Hi, I'm Daniel Lansky from Magnite Die Cutting, and what if I told you I could make your dies 25% cheaper and twice as strong? What we're talking about is called minimum bend radius. I'm going to tell you what minimum bend radius is, how it makes your die stronger, and why it makes them cheaper. Let's check it out. All right, so what is minimum bend radius? I've got this die to demonstrate exactly what it is. This right square right here is one continuous piece of rule, which means we've taken one long piece and at the corners we've bent as tight as we can, less than a 32nd of inch, all the corners. It's actually got a seam right here and it's so tight you can't even tell where the seam is. On the left side over here, we have individual pieces. So that means each side of this square is an individual piece of rule just like this. We put it in there and then we grind the edges and we bend it so it's real tight and it makes a nice square corner. So, as you can imagine, during the die cutting process, if all these corners are actually connected, this side here is going to be twice as strong, and during the actual die manufactured, we only have to make and bang in one continuous piece. The right side is cheaper and it's twice as strong as the left side. So, some of our customers have asked, but I really need square corners. They have to be nice and square and nice and tight. I can't have a radius corner. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this die and I'm gonna cut different types of material and I'm gonna let you decide if you can tell the difference between what was cut with the right side and what was cut with the left. Should be an interesting experiment. All right, now that we're done die cutting, let's take a look at what the results here are. I'm gonna zoom in on these pieces that I've made here. I've laid them out real nice for you, and they do not necessarily represent the left or the right side of the die. Here, we've got common copier paper. Over here, we have a thin plastic called Formex. It's used in the electrical industry. Here is just a standard polypropylene, about a 1/16 of an inch thick. And over here, what we have is our standard chipboard, about a 1/10 of an inch thick. Nice thick stuff. And then finally, I'm gonna show you some foam too. We got some foam here. So these parts I've mixed up purposely. I'm gonna pick them up, I'm gonna put them close to the camera, and you tell me which one you think this is. Look at the edge quality of each one. In fact, there is no way that you can tell the difference in any of these parts, which part was cut with which. They all come out very nice, clean corners. Their squares are excellent. But as you remember, the actual right side of the die is twice as strong and it's less expensive to manufacture. How often do you get that deal? I hope this video was able to explain what minimum bend radius is, why it's stronger and less expensive. If you like this video, please like it below. And the next time you call us here at Magnite, request minimum bend radius on your next die. Thank you.